the setup that I have. When I talk to a lot of people at the school, it's always the same story for them. It's, I came up with a musician. My parents played this instrument, and I just grew up playing this music. I grew up surrounded by music, so I got into it naturally. My parents don't know anything about music. No one in my family is a musician. No one in my family really knows that much about music. They appreciate it. It's fine. But they're not avid musicians. So the question then is always, how in the world did I get into music? Especially, like, if you know me, early music. How did I get into something that hasn't been around for like 400 years? Well, I can't really explain it to you other than I just played. I think I got lucky. Whoa, not with the stand word. I got lucky and I got a lot of the right pieces at the right time. So there have been plenty of moments in my life in which I wasn't too happy about playing music, in which I didn't want to continue playing music. And then the right piece would come along and I'd just be like, man, that one note, that one moment in time is just what I needed to remind me why I love what I do. So, you know, I think about all the concerts that I've put on where my aunt and uncle, who I live with, have been right there at the concert in the front row, definitely want to be there, want to support me, and they're knocked out. My uncle right there in the front row is snoring, just he just has no idea what he's doing at this concert other than he's there to watch and play. And like, as soon as it's over, he's right up. It's Battalia, written by Heinrich, who was a very famous composer back in the day. It was dedicated to Bacchus, who is the god of wine, mm-hmm. which is an interesting dedication for a piece that's about war. So it already gives it kind of an interesting nature for this piece. You're going to hear a lot of really bizarre techniques, especially for the era in which it was very much like you put the bow on the string, and you go this way, and then you go this way. Biber was kind of like, what if you do like this instead? And what if you put paper inside of the instrument? What if you hit things? What if you do all kinds of fun stuff? And so that's what you're gonna hear in this piece. I hope you enjoy it. It's gonna be neat. always are, in this area, we're still kind of, there's still some doubt about whether or not they can be used as virtuosic instruments. And this is one of those pieces that is like, yep, yes, they can. So, Allison and I will be playing the third one, which is my favorite. It's super fun. Thank you. the people that you play with are just as important as the pieces that you play. And I want to play with my friends. You know, I've been here for 5 years, I've made a lot of friends in all kinds of different things. And I was like, you know what? Let's just play with my friends. So this next piece is a piece that Jessica and I found together one day in the library. We were just like, hey, let's go look for bass duets. And we found a cello duet instead. This is a piece by Bernhard, who is a very famous cellist.
Thank you.
piece is from Edward Elgar, Variations, also known as the Enigma Variations. This is one of the more famous variations, and it's called Nimrod. It's a very slow variation, especially compared to some of the other ones, which are very quick. It turns out that these variations are musical representations of his friends. It started off apparently kind of as a joke, and then it kind of took a more serious turn, and he fleshed it out to a full piece, and it's one of his more famous pieces. Nimrod is specifically a movement about his friend Augustus J. Mayer, who was a music editor and his close friend, and there was a point in which Edward Elgar was very depressed and was considering giving up composing. And his friend Mayer came over and was like, you can't do this. Like, you think Beethoven didn't struggle, you think Wagner didn't struggle, like, they struggled, but they kept writing, so you have to keep writing too. And that got him out of his funk, he kept composing. And so this movement is the variation of that personality that Mayer encompassed. It's also one of the first pieces I ever played that legitimately made me cry during a concert. It's very beautiful, and I have actually arranged this for Six Bases. It's not originally written for Six Bases. It was originally written for a symphony orchestra. So, if you feel me, cry, you know, more power to you. to view these walls, please feel free to. I only ask that you go over there in the back, so that's not distracting to people who choose not to dance.
Thank you.
piece is written by Christian Gentet. I don't speak French, but he is a member of the orchestra, double basses, but in French, which is a surprise French group, double basses, six of them, and they play really cool stuff. This composition is in particular neat. It's called Bass, 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 and Bass. So, it's a mouthful. I don't know how I would say that in French, but I'm going to stick with English. But, I don't know about you guys. I don't know if you feel this, but like, I feel just a little bit overdressed.
Yeah! Oh!
We got one, guys. So